up, guys? Pikachu's you here, and today we are going to be starting out a new series on Plants vs. Zombies Garden Warfare 2. So this series is going to be about me doing showcases on characters that either I find not many people use or have, or don't, or that take the longest to find out what their actual special ability is. So for today's video, the first episode of this is going to be called Super Showcases, I'm going to be doing Hover Goat and Tortured, as I feel not as many people have them. And of course I don't have every character, I have every character apart from the legendaries and put 6-6 on. So I will not be able to be everyone, but when I do get the legendaries, I will showcase them. Okay, so let's start off with the Hover Goat. And I will play games with them, in the Team Vanquish as well. So for the first ability for the Hover Goat is the L1 ability. And when you are near a zombie, you can reflect on this down button. Okay. So when you're near a zombie and you press L1, it will go with this orange beam, kind of like the scientist kill beam, but instead of healing them, it gives them a damage buff. So they will do more damage to plants. As you scroll down. No, thank you, dude. Okay, so L1 ability, just a damage buff to the zombie that you are using it on. Okay, now for the triangle ability. And I am sorry, I'm only doing it for PS4 buttons, but I'm sure you can work it out and convert them to Xbox consoles if you do play on Xbox. So now, the triangle ability for the Hover Goat is the Mega Orphan Ranger, which varies in damage actually, depending on how close range you are. And of course, the beam will go down quicker your time. So it is time limited, but it will go down quicker when you're firing, of course. So it does, I think it's 13 damage close range hits, or critical hit, which is pretty good. And you can use that instead of the Radical Rose gun if you want. I usually use it against Tortured if I find any Tortured in the game and I'm playing it every day. Or against the Super Champ, I usually use it against. Okay, so the triangle ability, the Mega Orphan Ranger. Okay, so now for the R1 ability, for the Hover Goat 3000. Who's that? Barbecue Boy. Let's just take him out. Oh yeah. Okay, so the R1 ability for the Hover Goat 3000 generation Phantom Edge is so when you press it around zombies, they will get a speed buff and you will get a speed buff as well. So you can run pretty fast. And I find this useful for if you see a trumpet bearing towards you, you can just quickly use your R1 ability to get away, and then the trumpet can't follow you by bearing. And if you are a lot of teammates around you, and there are a lot of plants that's not too far away but a bit far away, you can use it on all your teammates so you can all get a good speed buff. Okay, now that is all of the abilities for the Hover Goat. So now we're going to move on to the Tortured, and then we'll play some multiplayer matches. Okay, let's get in there. Character boost. Okay, the Tortured. And also, I don't know if I have the abilities on them. Let me just check. No, I don't. Do I have them on the Hover Goat? I think I have them on the Hover Goat. No, I don't. Oh, we won't use them on the Tortured then, sure, otherwise it would be unfair. none, and none. Okay, so the Torchwood class. He's a very good class. His normal weapon is the Witcher one. It's pretty nice. He kind of had to charge up at the start, like when he's using a blue star, unless he's zooming and then fire. And then, okay, let's get into his L1 triangle and R1 abilities. So we will start with the L1 ability, which is Blazing Blast. So if you find yourself surrounded by a group of zombies, you can use your Blazing Blast, which is like, you can breathe fire, and all around the zombies to burn them, like this, and to destroy them and get out quickly, if you can. So that's a pretty useful ability if you find yourself very close range to a zombie. Or a few zombies as well, it's good to take out multiple zombies at once. Okay, so the triangle ability, Smoldering Madness. Okay. So your torchwood essentially turns bigger. And when it shoots, it will shoot fire out. So the enemy will get burnt. Yeah, if you stand still and shoot, it takes out less than if you move and shoot. So I suggest standing still and shooting if you can when you do it. It's a pretty useful ability. It's very good for long range. To take out this guy. Yeah, it's a pretty useful ability. For a bit of long range as well, and it does do the burn as well, so it can burn the zombies, which is nice and useful. Okay, so now for the final ability of the Torchwood. This is the Leaf Shield. So you put your Leaf Shield up, and it literally just the shield someone to attack us, makes them do less damage. Because Captain Cannon wouldn't do full damage with one of his shots. It protects you from a lot of damage. Which is quite helpful as well if you do want to get away. But it does, I believe, slow you down. Okay. Just destroy it. Okay. So now, let's get into some multiplayer matches. And I'll see you when I'm in one. Okay guys, we are loading in to a game of Team Vanquish in the Aqua Center. So if we're on plants or zombies will depend on which character we use. Okay, we're on plants, so we use the Torchwood guys. That's just me and myself. There's barely any people. Okay, there we are. There's not many people. The 5v4, but we do still get to showcase the Torchwood. But there's an all-star over there. So if we can just get close range, that would be handy. Whoa! A Blazing Blast, and then our Digger was Smoldering Madness. Okay, let's put up our Leaf Shield. Kind of stay here for a bit so we can get our health up. Okay, he's done. Okay. There is an all-star over there. Can you sneak behind him? He's got Blazing Blast. Shared Vanquish. And we all want to sneak a three. This character is very good. And we have another Torchwood in our team. No. Okay, we dropped the VPC nicely. And we got another Shared Vanquish. Okay, let's put up our Leaf Shield. No, he's frozen us. Okay, we are extremely low health. Sunflower, please. Sunflower. Yay, the sunflower's eating us. Okay, let's go into our smoldering room. There's one right here. Wait for people to come around. Okay, we're gonna run out of it. Let's try and wait here. So if they do come through this way, there we go. Blazing blast! Unless somebody else takes them out. Okay. Let's try and go round here. See if there's anybody. Don't seem like there's anybody here. So let's go around a minute. There is a zombie sink cloud, which is evidence that there is a foot soldier nearby. Blazing blast! No! Oh, quick, I need help. Where's that sunflower? No, I need the sunflower to come quick. Okay. Been swallowed. Where is the sunflower? We haven't been down just once yet. Okay, that all-star is down. We've got a suppression issue. Hey, blazing blast. No! We were destroyed. What vanquish streak did we get on? We got on 6 vanquish streak. Just do think. And our torch wood is nearly every time. Okay, let's go over here. There is a hobby boat in there. That is interesting. No thank you, hobby boat. And no thank you is fire versus fire. No, hobby boat. Yeah, the hobby boat vanquished her. There's some reason here, the mega is amazing. I think the Hot Wolf Temple is trying to revive us. But unfortunately she did that too. Let's try and shoot down that soldier. One more vanquish and we are done it. We might have got the highest vanquish streak as well. Let's see if we did. Can't win by a few people. No, we didn't get them. Okay guys, I hope you enjoyed that match and I'll see you in the next one where hopefully we can be Hover Goat and have a match with him. See you then. Hey guys, we are back and as the Hover Goat 3000. Let's go! Let's give a buff to this Camo Ranger. Hopefully we can do some more damage. Okay. Let's give us a mystery. Now! Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. And also, Rose can't go to 5. Probably got 2 apples to move. We can't use that, but we will still get out quickly, isn't it? That chunk is dangerous because we don't have our speed buff, and if we borrow it, we will not be able to get away. So let's quickly run. Have we gone underground? No. Hopefully down. I don't know if we have a star. Okay. Let's give it death of a tank man. Also, the hover goat does not revive any quicker than a normal zombie. Just revives the same speed as any other zombie but the scientist. And it does do less damage to plants in like a few that one. Okay. Run out of our mega orphanage. So let's see what I can do. Obviously I've done that one. Maybe it's only one other person. Oh no, an armor trumpet. Run. you might be okay because it's just very December. If you didn't even cancel. Okay, let's quickly go. Mega awesome laser time. Okay, bam. No! Oh! We were in our mega awesome laser, so we could not get away from the team leader quick enough. If the zombies are winning this match, give this guy a buff. Okay, man, we just won something. Oh no! No! Oh no, we were destroyed. Was that by Agent P? Yes, it was, with the key silencer. Restore. Okay. Zombies still winning, which is good. More coins for Rux. Okay, bam, taken down. Give it to the little girl because he goes in the net. Then he will be a monster. So one shot again. A speed weapon. Where's the other car? This is where I saw one landing. Is he still with us yet? Oh, there's an agent here. Let's go for... Oh yeah, it's powering up. Speed buffer as well. Get down. Bring it down. Yeah, we did get speed up. Okay, let's go. Wait, what? Where are the enemies? Whoa, Chili Bean Bomb, run! Okay. I was gonna destroy this. Yes. Oh, we grew up to level 5 and it's a whole generation upgrade. Are we still winning? 4 more vanquishes to go. And bam, we are on the floor. Yes, and we got the last vanquish. Woo. I love the gestures on the hover deck. They're really cool. And the torchwood one goes just pump in the air. And there's the dancing one. Okay guys, so that was showcasing the Hover Goat 3000 and Torchwood. I hope you enjoyed and learned a bit more about these characters. And I'll see you in the next episode. Bye!